do you think you're doing throwing partially drunk milk bottles through my window?
Well, you haven't got a doorbell, have you?
And no, we haven't got a doorbell, but you could have knocked, couldn't you?
No, I couldn't, actually, because I've sprained my wrist.
Have you? How'd you do that?
Throwing the bottle through the window.
Anyway, that's not even my window. That's my window.
Oh, that one.
That one. Now come inside. Mm.
So, Jim, what's those two birds doing in here, then?
Oh, Bob, it was terrible last night. My dad had his weeds bored out.
So?
Them's me auntie and uncle.
Jim, what on earth is your father up to over there?
Bob, brilliant, look.
The Alan Ladd Memorial Heel Bar. And he'll do your shoes for you.
I don't believe it.
Come over, he will.
I do not believe it.
Hello there.
Father! Father! Father, will you do Bob's shoes for him?
Good afternoon, sir. Have you known Mexico long, or do you use a cordless telephone? Holidays, it's a nice. Always nice to get away with the long-lasting bar. Wee wee. Ooh, mustn't say that,
Jim,
sir.
Jim, can we just go?
Telephone.
What's the matter? Don't you want your nails doing?
Anyway, dig in, sir. It's all free.
I don't know what I'm doing, actually. It's quite embarrassing.
Father, we're just going away for the weekend.
It's a lovely heel bar, it really is. Very smart.
Very talented.
Very multi-talented.
All right, Grussnake man.
All right.
You have an important uncle coming round to borrow your Argos catalogue.
You've got an important uncle, haven't you, Bob?
Yep.
Mary Casterbridge.
That's the one, yeah.
Anyway, he's coming round to borrow your Argos catalogue, but unfortunately you've mislaid it. So instead you lent him A, a carrier bag full of old engine parts, B, a carpet with an elf's head cut out of the middle, C.
A box of contaminated soil with the words Ministry of Defence on it.
D.
An afro comb previously used for grounding.
E. A 70-year-old Stilton
with a tight woman's belt round it.
That's probably one of those nice bright red belts that you like, Bob.
Yeah, they're smart, then.
Answer on back.
Jim, it doesn't matter. He's not coming.
How did you know the answer to that?
Because he telephoned me and said his axle's cracked.
Give me that paper here. Let's see what's on this weekend. Meat festival.
Meat festival. Hey, we like meat, don't we?
Meat smart.
Let's go then, yeah?
Come on then.
Are we?
Are we, Jim, man? We'll be late. The coach goes in half an hour.
Hello there, I'm your driver, Spencer Pendle. Now, we've got a nice, clean bus here, and I'd like to keep it that way, if you don't mind. Now that means no litter or loose paper. Are you listening, woman? I can smell drink on your breath. You're an alcoholic, aren't you? Go on, get off. Get off my bus.
All right, Jim.
All right, Bob.
Now, Jim, can you tell me what popular mask I'm thinking of?
Well, now, Bob, you could be thinking of two masks.
You could be thinking of the Phantom of the Opera, which is quite popular at the moment, or you could be thinking of the Lone Ranger.
Well, which one are you saying?
The Phantom of the Opera.
No, Batman's.
I knew it as well.
All right, Jim.
All right, Bob. Now, it's Saturday afternoon, right? And I'm having a nice bit of cake. Is it a Battenberg, a Dayton walnut, or a nice fresh cream sponge?
Oh, that's easy, Bob. It's a nice fresh cream sponge.
No, it's not, because it's Saturday, you see. It's a Battenberg.
Damn! Oh, and you gave us a clue as well.
Clue was in the question.
What's an ass?
Meat festival!
I know you two. You murdered my brother and his family, brutally, mind.
7 years ago, to this very day.
Well, you don't get away with that sort of behaviour with me.
Look, Jim, if it's what you really want, why don't you just buy it?
I don't know.
Have you gone and have a look at some others?
What's your life?
Can I lay a deposit on it?
What?
No! A monetary deposit!
Hey, we're having a laugh here, aren't we?
Yeah. Come on, let's have a look at the other stall.
All right.
Hello.
Hello.
Turkey seepage. Can I try this one, please?
Certainly, sir. I think you'll like that. My husband scraped it out last month.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh!
I must have this meat product.
That gentleman over there has laid a deposit on this meat.
He's done what?
No, a monetary deposit.
What?
Oh, no!
Perfect! I'll take that, please.
Right, I think I've made my mind up. There's just a couple of questions. One, is it less than 30% fat?
Yes.
Two, Bob thinks it might be a bit heavy, so can I test it?
Yes.
Thanks. Yeah? It's all right. I think I'm going to take it.
Oh, brilliant.
I hope I'm doing the right thing.
I think you are doing the right thing, yeah. It's a nice meat.
Excuse me.
What?
We will buy that meat product from you.
No, I put a lot of thought into this.
Yeah, you put a lot of thought into it.
We'll give you £300 for it.
No, no, you should have got here earlier. Say, because the early bird catches the crop. Time loves a hero.
He who waits is great.
Come by, army lordy.
Oh, come all ye faithful.
Chidley on pom pom.
We showed you no marks, didn't we? Now on your bike.
Yeah, bye, you know.
Bye, you know.
Could we have a double room for the evening, please?
Certainly, sir. We have a standard room tariff with ensuite shower, air conditioning, trouser press, heated towel rail with a selection of towels in white, cream and peach.
Peach?
Tea and coffee facilities and television with movie channel.
Smart and interesting. We'll take one, please.
Thank you, sir. Room 8350190000. Enjoy your stay and here are your complimentary gloves.
Thank you very much indeed.
May we have a room for the night, please?
Single? Double?
We don't mind, so long as it's double and next to those two previous residents, please.
Certainly, sir. Room 7.
I think this will work.
Room service!
Come in! Settling in nicely, sir. I've brought your Bible, sir.
I love eggnog, mate.
Oh, sir. What a lovely sausage. It's a little warm in here, sir. It could cause hardening, sir. Allow me to place it in our refrigerator, sir. It would be best, sir!
That sausage stays here!
Hole on pepper pot blocked. Running horse leads to cash.
Did you ask to be serviced?
No, not for a long time.
From Bush. Fat bloke still in
pasture. I love eggnog.
Cloud covering.
That was a good 15-hour kip.
15's a number, Bob.
Yeah. Are you going to be sleeping in your eye there, Jim?
What? So, let me get this straight then, Bob. Mustache over the top lip, beard covers the entire lower jaw, fringe hangs over the forehead, and eyebrow over the top of the eye.
Well done, I knew you'd get it. Still no reply from the hairdressing school, though, eh?
No, I'm still waiting.
I like eggnog, me, Bob.
I tell you what, those fellas were desperate to get hold of my speciality meat product.
Yeah, but you wouldn't give it to them, though, would you?
No, I wouldn't. The meat is mine. God, Bob! This plush is alive with static.
I'm just going to bog.
Jim, what the handbag carnival partridge underbelt's going on here?
Bob, it's like this. These three gentlemen here are aliens, and they need my specialty meat product to feed their queen so she may pupate and thus ensure the survival of their race. So I've given it to them in exchange for them being my slaves for half an hour.
Shut it.
Come here. Come on. Jim, you're an honest man, a nice man, right? A pleasant fella. But you're a gullible, guileless simpleton, aren't you?
It's true, man!
Stop that, right? Now, look, yesterday we could have got 400 quid for this. That would have bought some bricks, a nice sheet of polythene, and partway towards buying a tomato farm.
Come here! Show him what you showed me.
You see, they've been wearing the guise of humans so they can pass undetected in the human world. But now you can see them in the true forms.
Jim, they're not true forms.
Not the shoes, man, the true forms, their real IDs. Now, we've got to get them back to the spaceship.
Why, aye, man. It's all true what the kidder says. We need the speciality meat to feed War Queen so she can make worms like. You know, because that's how we started off as like, as bairns and that. Oh, our planet'll be knocked.
That's them, Sarge.
Right, you lot better come with me to the station. Otherwise, you'll jolly well suffer for it.
Well, what have they done?
For the past 3 months, these blighters have been pilfering speciality meats from innocent shopkeepers the length and breadth of the country, causing all manner of shortcomings.
You can't do that. I've still got 20 minutes of slavery left.
Look, Copper, never mind your petty meat product-based misdemeanors and felonies, right? We've got a planet to save.
Oh! Hey, you, that's not on.
Look, Jim, what's going on here?
He's freeze-dried them with his special eyeballs, so we've got to get them into that booth.
Jim, that's not a booth, it's more of a kiosk, that.
No, Bob, if it was a kiosk, it'd have a shelf in it.
No, if it was a kiosk, there'd be a counter. Shelving, you're thinking of a pantry.
So what's a kiosk without shelving and a counter?
That's a booth.
Exactly, that's a booth.
How we're used to. These police are only frozen for 30 seconds!
Run!
Where's my ship? You parked it.
By an old discarded pram.
Look it up in the A to Z.
Old discarded pram. Old discount warehouse. Old disgraced athlete. Old disfigured woman. Old diseased man. Old disprin. Old discarded clam. Old discarded pram. Got it. Behind hedge 8, area B.
Let's go!
Stop for, Jim! Jim, stop that. Come on. Come on, Jim. Well, thanks for all your help.
Hey, brilliant, no problem, you nice people. You look a bit daft-like.
Well, what more can we say?
Oi! You lot! Where's my bleeding mate?
Oh, no! That's our queen!
What are we gonna do?
Oh, the sausage! Go on, Bob.
Jim, you can hardly be trusted with anything these days, can you?
You're supposed to be the produce guardian.
Oh, not today.
Gilbert, stop!
Is that this what you're looking for?
The speciality meat product! Hurrah! Hurrah!
Thanks, Copper. Thanks, lads. Now, if there's out we can defears.
Hey, yeah. Could you turn Jim's aunt and uncle back to the former selves?
Why, aye, kidder. It's as good as done, like. You know, we've got to learn to live together. But before we can, we've got to learn to give as well as take. You know, as cultures may be apart, but caring can knock down any barriers. If only others had followed your example, it'd be a canny world like you now.
Oi! Get that meat in here now! I'm absolutely busting for it!
We'd better go.
What?
I like aliens.
I thought it was eggnog you liked.
I'm allowed to like more than one thing, Anna.
All right then. You like aliens and eggnog.
Yes, I do, fancy pants. All right then, Bob.
What?
I'm in the stationer's shop and I'm going to buy quite a hard piece of stationery. What is it?
Stationer's hard item, that's easy. That's a franking machine.
Oh, blimey, I don't know how you do it.
I'm not bad, am I?
Do you want to come in for an eggnog?
I don't like eggnog, but yes, I'll come in.
Jim, what are these two foxes doing in here?
Bob! It worked! Auntie and Uncle! They're back!
It's them!
I can't believe it.